Lesson 11, The Discomfiture of Shaista Khan. Now, in the last lesson, we had already learned about the brave deeds of Baji Prabhu and how it helped Shivaji in establishing Swaraj. In this lesson, we see how Shivaji's brave deeds carried on and he was a threat to the Mughals. Now, we will start our lesson, Shaista Khan's campaign. As I told you, this Mughal, that is Adil Shah of Bijapur, could not force Shivaji to surrender. He did all the things possible. He did not leave a stone unturned in his efforts to put Shivaji in place. But it was all in vain. He sent every Sardar possible, but they were all defeated by Shivaji. At last, Adil Shah gave up the fight and made peace with Shivaji. And not only that, he gave him an independent kingdom. At last, Shivaji had some peace in the southern borders. This was the story of the southern borders. But what happened in the north? The Mughal attacks from the north had partially ruined Maharashtra. Now what happened? Shivaji did not like all these things. Shivaji therefore turned his attention towards the north and he started carrying out raids in the territories of the Mughal emperor Aurangzeb. Now when Aurangzeb came to know about all this, what Shivaji was doing, he was angry and he sent his uncle Shaista Khan to deal with Shivaji. He told him, go and teach this Shivaji a lesson. And so now Shaista Khan, Aurangzeb's uncle, left with a huge army of 75,000 men and hundreds of elephants, camels and pieces of cannon, and he marched on Pune. On the way, Shaista Khan did not keep quiet. He went on capturing the towns of Shirwal, Shivpur, Saswad, and finally he laid a siege to the fort of Purandar. I have already explained to you the meaning of the word siege. It means that he surrounded the fort and all the supplies to the fort was cut. But nothing could do anything to Shivaji and his troops. Shivaji had a particular and a specific way of fighting against his enemy. What was it? Maratha Sardars were very, very quick. They were quick on their Bheem Thadi ponies. And they followed one thing. That is, they only carried few things as ration along with them. And what was it? Only onions and bajra bread. They knew all the hills and valleys and they took the shortest route possible. Therefore, the Marathas were always victorious and kept on forwarding, moving ahead to harass the Mughals. At last, Shaista Khan did not know what to do because he was not familiar of this warfare which the Marathas used. Now, he at last was tired and he raised the siege of Purandar. Firangoji Narsala. Shaista Khan continued his march on Pune. He first captured the fort of Chakan. When he captured the fort of Chakan, Firangoji Narsala, a brave soldier who was so brave that he fought to defend the fort with great bravery and skill against the army of Shaista Khan. It was 2 months that Shaista Khan was fighting against this soldier, Firangoji Narsala, but he did not give up. At last, Firangoji Narsala was helpless against the guns of Shaista Khan. Seeing Firangoji Narsala fight with such great bravery, Shaista Khan was impressed and he offered Firangoji Narsala service with the Mughal emperor. But this great soldier, this Sardar, the Maratha Sardar Firangoji, refused this tempting offer because he was a loyal soldier. Shaista Khan in Lal Mahal. Shaista Khan came to Pune and made Lal Mahal Shivaji's residence his headquarters. Now what happened? This is Shivaji's house. But Shaista Khan made it his own and he started living in this palace. Now this Shaista Khan did not only stay in Lal Mahal, but he also started troubling the people. His troops would raid Shivaji's territory, destroy crops and take away the cattle. And so the people and the country was devastated. A bold plan. We are all aware that Shivaji loved his people. He wanted to bring about peace and therefore he established Swaraj. When he saw that the Mughal army were destroying the country and troubling the people, he could not keep quiet. What did Shivaji do? Shivaji decided to teach Shaista Khan a lesson. Now Shivaji knew all the places inside out because it was his own house. He knew the entrance, the exit, its secret passages, doors and windows. And besides this, Shivaji's spies were keeping him well informed about the disposition of the Khan's army. What is the meaning of this? Shivaji's spies would tell him regularly where the Khan's troops were kept. They were standing at which place? How were they guarding Lal Mahal? And so it was very, very easy for Shivaji to take a bold decision to enter Lal Mahal and kill Shaista Khan. Now Lal Mahal was well guarded. It was very difficult to enter it. Why? Because there were so many troops that Shaista Khan had along with him. 75,000 troops who were campaigning outside the palace. And no armed Sardar, that is a Maratha Sardar, was not allowed to enter into the place. So Shivaji had to make quite a good plan if he wanted to succeed. He decided to enter Lal Mahal. He fixed a date and on the 5th of April 1663, a marriage procession was passing along the streets of Pune. There was music and fireworks accompanied by a lot of people who were passing the procession. They were well dressed, hundreds of them, and some were in palanquin. Some were walking on foot. Shivaji, with his band of trusted followers, joined the marriage procession. Everyone felt that they were part of the marriage procession. After some time, when the procession passed or proceeded on its way, Shivaji and his men moved away quietly in the direction of Lal Mahal. At that time, it was night. And Shaista Khan was fast asleep. Shaista Khan learns a lesson. Shaista Khan was fast asleep and Shivaji entered Lal Mahal. How did he enter? He made a hole in the wall and quickly went into the palace. The Khan's bodyguards were half asleep because it was night. And Shivaji slowly went deeper and deeper inside the palace. And as he was going, he saw someone approaching him. He thought it was Shaista Khan and he killed him. But later he came to know that it was not Shaista Khan, but his son. In the commotion that happened, that took place as Shivaji killed Shaista Khan's son, people woke up and Shaistha Khan was sleeping in his chamber. But Shivaji went right into Shaistha Khan's chamber and wanted to kill him with a sword. Seeing Shivaji, the Khan was terrified. He was scared and he started shouting, "Devil, devil!" And he wanted to escape through the window. But Shivaji would not leave him. He struck him with his sword and cut off his three fingers. The Khan could have lost his life. Now the Khan escaped through the window. You can see how he is just running away to save his life. The Khan was lucky enough to escape through the window and save his life. And at that time, to deceive the Khan's troops, Shivaji and his men started shouting, "Shivaji has attacked! Run, catch him! Run, catch! Shivaji has attacked!" Listening to this, the Khan's troops all started running in all directions. They were all confused because they wanted to catch Shivaji and his men. In the midst of the confusion, Shivaji and his men escaped from that place and they reached Sinhagad. Now here, the Khan's troops spent the whole night looking for Shivaji and his troops. But they weren't there. They had already escaped. The Shaistha Khan now was frightened. He was so scared. He thought, "In the first attack, I lost my three fingers. Maybe I will lose my head in the second." And so he was all scared. When Aurangzeb came to know about the incident that took place, he was very furious. He was angry on his uncle, Shaistha Khan. And so Shaistha Khan lost the emperor's favor. And he was sent, that is transferred, to Bengal. Now this was a big blow for Aurangzeb, that is the Mughal power. Shivaji had successfully bearded the lion in his own den. This was a great risk that Shivaji had taken, but he was successful. Gunfire announced the victory and a wave of joy went all over Maharashtra. Thank you.